welcome back to the Rock at Home Summer Edition. As you can see, my background looks very different than our rock videos normally do. I am here at the church. I am doing some VBS prep and getting all ready for VBS. I hope you are excited for it if you're signed up. And so I decided I would just do the rock video from here today. So thank you very much to everyone who sent in your fruit frenzy pictures. They were hilarious. I love getting these photos from you guys every week. They make me laugh so much. I love it so much. So this week's caption is sunglasses for the win. So get creative with that. Send me your best photos for sunglasses for the win. And we're like way more than halfway over this contest. The summer is coming to a close very quickly. So we will soon discover who our top three winners are, which I'm very excited about. Now, before we get into our Bible lesson, we are going to sing a song as usual. And today we are going to do a little bit of a tongue twister again. This is a song that I sang when I was your age, when I was in Sunday school, and I love it very much. And we've sang it already this summer once. So let's go sing I Am a Sea. Okay, that one's always a tongue twister and you gotta try and sing it faster and faster every time. I love it so much. So today's Bible story, we are learning a little bit about what it means to follow Jesus and the cost of following Jesus. Have you guys ever saved up for something before and like you had to count the cost of like what it was going to be? Like you can't just say, oh, I want a bike and then go to the store and buy a bike. Like you have to do some research. You gotta figure out how much it costs and then you gotta save up for it. When I was a kid, I would be saving up for something and I would know how much allowance I was gonna get each week. And so I would figure out, okay, if I do this many chores every day for 3 weeks, then I'm gonna have enough money to save up for a new video game or a bike or whatever it is that I wanted to buy. And so I had to count the cost and figure out what it was going to cost me. And you know, we talk a lot about as Christians how wonderful it is to be a Christian and how much God loves us, and all of that is true. It is true that it is wonderful to be a Christian and that we then have God in our lives and He helps us through things. But in today's story, Jesus is talking to a group of people and to His disciples about the cost of following Jesus, because here's the thing, it is not easy to be a Christian because the world is against us. The world doesn't want us to believe in Jesus and it's gonna fight against us. It's gonna say, you don't really need to do that. You can just do whatever you want. Just like Satan in the garden, right? Eve and Adam were following Jesus, but Satan didn't want them to. And he was like, do you really have to follow God? Like, why do you really have to follow these rules? And then the cost of that was that sin entered the world. And so for us as Christians, we are gonna face hard times, or we're gonna face things in this world because we're Christians. But the thing is that because we are Christians, we have God on our side and He can help us through those things. So let's watch our video now to figure out what exactly the cost is of following Jesus.
Large crowds traveled with Jesus. Many people wanted to follow Him. One man said, "Teacher, I will follow you wherever you go." Jesus told the man, "Foxes have dens and birds of the sky have nests, but the Son of Man has no place to lay His head." Another disciple said, "Lord, I will follow you, but first let me go and bury my father." Jesus replied, "Follow me and let the dead bury their own dead." Jesus told the people that following Him wouldn't be easy. It would cost them a lot. "Anyone who comes to me must be willing to leave his family. You must love me most of all more than your own life. Anyone who is unwilling to suffer cannot be my disciple, Jesus said. Jesus urged the people to think about what they were doing. He told them a story. If you wanted to build a tower, you would first sit down and figure out what it would take to complete the tower. Otherwise, you would build the foundation and be unable to finish. People would laugh at you. Then he told them another story. If you were a king, you wouldn't go to war against another king without considering whether your army would be great enough to win the war. If you have too few men to fight, you would send some men to ask for peace before the battle even started. Jesus wanted the people to consider the cost. If you are not willing to give up everything you have, you cannot follow me, Jesus said. Following Jesus means giving him complete control of your life. That is not easy, but it is worth it. Jesus said, "Whoever gives up his life for me will find true life. What good is it to have everything you want in the world if you give up life with God forever?" Jesus taught that following him is not easy. It requires commitment and sacrifice. When we trust in Jesus, we give him complete control over our lives. True life is found in Jesus, who gave up his life to rescue us from sin and death. He is worth it.
Okay, so Jesus was talking to his disciples and other people about the cost that it takes to be a Christian. And see, a lot of the time, including the people in the Bible, they said to Jesus, like, oh, I'll follow you, I'll do whatever it takes. But then Jesus said, okay, but have you considered the cost? Have you actually thought about it? Or are you just kind of jumping in? Because it's important that we actually think and plan ahead of time. Just like Jesus says, when someone's building a house, you first have to figure out the foundation. You can't just start building a house or it's going to fall over. People are going to kind of laugh at you. And then same when you're like going to war against a king, you wouldn't just jump into a situation without figuring out first what the cost is going to be. And it's the same for us in deciding if we want to follow Jesus or not. And like I said earlier, and like the video said, it is so worth it, but we just have to go into it knowing what we're getting ourselves into. Because the thing is, we live in a sinful world, and so the people of this world, they're not gonna appreciate Jesus, they're not gonna want us to follow Jesus. They wanna be able to do whatever they want, and they're gonna wanna bring you with them. And so there are gonna be times as you get older where you're gonna have to face the cost of following Jesus, and maybe it'll look like not doing something that all the people in your class are doing. They all get to do this. They all get to go see a movie maybe, or they all get to go to some sort of event, but you know that as a Christian, you really shouldn't do that. You shouldn't be watching that movie because it's not appropriate, or you shouldn't be going to that event because bad things are gonna happen there. And so you have to stand out. You have to look different than everybody else. And sometimes it is so hard to be different than everybody else. We wanna just blend in and fit in so that people can't point fingers at us and be like, why are you weird? Why are you different? And that's one of the costs of following Jesus, is standing out and being okay with that. And you know what? Sometimes you get made fun of for following Jesus, but again, it is so worth it. And so as you grow up, you have to be able to face those things and know that Jesus is so worth it. Because put it this way, all the things that you face here on earth, they're only a short amount of time compared to all of eternity. And so, would you rather live an amazing life here on earth, getting to do whatever you want, not following Jesus for a really short amount of time, but then spend all of eternity away from God and not in heaven? You have to compare the cost, right? The cost is that here on earth, we may not fit in, we may get fun of, we may not get to do everything that we want to do, but the thing that we get for paying that price is eternity with Jesus in heaven. So you have to compare one to the other. It's not like you have to live an uncomfortable life that isn't always great and you get nothing for it. It's like going to the store. You don't give them their money and then just walk out without getting something. We pay this price of being followers of Jesus, but the thing that we get in return is greater than any gift or anything on the entire planet. It's that we get a personal relationship with Jesus and we get to spend all of eternity in heaven with him. And the other amazing thing about being a Christian is that when you face those hard times and you face those troubles, you have Jesus with you. Think about it, the rest of the world, even though they get to kind of do whatever they want, they still face troubles, they still go through hard times, they still get sick, people in their lives still pass away and die, they still face all the sin in this world, but they have to do it alone, they have to do it without Jesus. But for us as Christians, we get to face those times where we get sick, where we have to move and we don't want to, when a family member dies, we face those things with Jesus in our life and we can rely on him wholeheartedly through those things. And so that is the cost of following Jesus, but it is so worth it in the end. And I hope and pray that when you guys face hard times and you face those issues or someone pushing back against you and saying, hey, you don't need to follow this Jesus, like just come with us and we can do whatever we want. I hope that you stand firm in your faith and know that Jesus is worth it. And just think about the fact that he died on the cross for us. He knew that his death was worth us being able to have a relationship with him and live in eternity in heaven with him forever. So that is what our lesson is on today. It is a hard lesson that we all have to learn over and over and over again. That is a lesson that I am still learning. You never stop learning it and you never stop having to count the cost of following Jesus. So I hope and pray that you all will count the cost and still think Jesus is worth it. Okay, thanks again for joining. We will see you guys next week. Bye.